Hey YouTube, it's your boy LRF, and today we have an exciting video for you. We have the Klipsch RP260F versus the SVS Prime Tower Speakers. And what we're going to be doing today, I will be giving you a few specs and dimensions of these speakers, and then we will go into a full demo battle between these two tower speakers. Then I'll give you guys the opportunity to weigh in and tell me which one you believe is the better speaker. So in the meantime, sit back, relax, and get ready for this episode. No. Alright, so welcome back guys, and as you can see, in front of me we have the Klipsch RP260F, and as well as the SVS Prime Tower Speakers standing in front of us. As you can see, the Klipsch is 2 to 3 inches taller than the SVS Towers, but that doesn't necessarily mean anything when it comes to audio performance. So, but first, coming to the Klipsch speakers, the color right in front of you is ebony, and at the top with the tweeter is a 1-inch travel suspension titanium tweeter, full 6.5-inch spun copper ceramic cone woofers, and 90x90 hybrid Traxxas horn. Is built with an MDF cabinet with brushed polymer on flexible removable grill. With the specs now, the frequency response is from 34 hertz to 25,000 kilohertz, plus or minus 3 decibels. And the sensitivity is 97 decibels. The power handling is 125 watts with peaks out at 500 watts. The impedance in ohms is 8 ohms, of course, and the crossover frequency is 1800 hertz. Bass now, it's a rear firing bass reflex port. That is just some of the specs. There's still a lot more, but I think at this point those are the more important ones that we should focus on. So all right, now over to the SVS Prime Tower. The finish is a premium black ash wood grain. It has a 1-inch tweeter, 1/2-inch mid-range, and dual 6.5-inch woofers. Also has an MDF cabinet, stiff removable grill. Frequency response is from 30 hertz to 25,000 kilohertz, plus or minus 3 decibels, and the sensitivity is 87 decibels. SVS does it slightly different with how they tell you how to power the speakers. They recommend you to use amplification from 20 to 250 watts for these speakers. And this is also 8 ohms, and the speaker is a configuration of a 3.5-way crossover. Alright, so now that we got that little tech specs out of the way, let's get into the main battle. I wanna thank y'all for coming to see the preacher's son alive.
Thank you. Fellas, hold on to your girl right now. Yo, right now we gon' slow the whole dance floor down. Take it back to the old school. Let's go.
Baby, let me holla at you. I wanna thank y'all for coming to see the preacher's son alive.
Thank you.
Fellas, hold on to your girl right now.
Yo, right now we gon' slow the whole dance floor down. Take it back to the old school. Let's go.
Baby, let me holla at you. I wanna thank y'all for coming to see the preacher's son alive.
Thank you.
Fellas, hold on to your girl right now.
Yo, right now we gon' slow the whole dance floor down. Take it back to the old school. Let's go.
Baby, let me holla at you. Your son alive.
Thank you.
Fellas, hold on to your girl right now.
Yo, right now we gon' slow the whole dance floor down. Take it back to the old school. Let's go.
Baby, let me holla at you.
Thank you.
all right, guys, that's about it for the audio battle. As we already know, Klipsch is known for their track trips horn. As we know, SVS is known for their three-way crossover. I spent a lot of time with both of these speakers, and I'm torn on which one sound better personally. But enough about that. It was time for you guys to decide which one sound better. I'll be putting a poll right here for you guys to click and vote which one sound better. I'll be adding it to the comment section to let you guys know which one came out on top. If you guys enjoyed this video, please remember to thumbs up, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.